Welcome to Blender Days. In this video, we will see about 3D cursor in toolbar. 3D cursor is placed next to selection tool. By default, it is located in the world origin XYZ 0,0,0. 3D cursor option is also available at the top of transform pivot menu. Right click and select snap. It shows snap menu. This snap menu contains 8 items. Press shift S. It shows 8-sided snap pop-up menu, which contains the same 8 items we just saw in the snap menu. User can use the snap menu by right clicking or by pressing shift S. If the 3D cursor is misplaced, no issue, we can bring it back. Press shift S, then select cursor to world origin. Now the cursor is back to the origin. Press shift S, it shows the pop-up menu. The top 4 items are related to selection. Next 4 items are related to 3D cursor. Right click and the snap menu contains the same 8 items. Those are selection to grid, selection to cursor, selection to cursor with the keep offset, selection to active, then cursor to selected, cursor to world origin, cursor to grid, cursor to active. In shift S pop-up menu, it contains selection items at top and cursor items at bottom. Select the 3D cursor tool on toolbar. Click on star object or click wherever you needed to change its location. Click on sponge to place 3D cursor on it. Select the select box tool and select the teapot. Press shift S and select the selection to cursor. Here teapot is selected, it is moved to cursor's position. Now click on floor to place the 3D cursor on grid. Select teapot with the selection tool. Press shift S and selection to cursor. Now click on beam to place the cursor on beam. Press W for selection tool and select sponge. Press shift S and selection to cursor. To bring the 3D cursor to its origin, shift S, then select cursor to world origin. Now we shall see about selection to active. In Blender, while selecting multiple objects by holding shift, the last selected object, sponge, is appearing bright yellow. Now I am selecting beam, honeycomb and sponge. Finally the teapot to make it as an active object in the selection. Select star, then shift click on beam. Among this, star appears with orange outline, beam appears with bright yellow outline. Now selecting star and teapot. Among this selection, star appears bright yellow. Select all, finally teapot. Now the teapot is active object. Now clicking honeycomb and sponge, then beam. Beam is active object, appears with the bright yellow among this selection. Press shift S and the selection to active. Now the selected object moved to the active beam object. Undo and right click and select selection to cursor from snap menu. It does the same result. Select star, teapot, beam, then finally sponge. Sponge is active now. Right click snap and select, selection to active. Selected objects moved to sponge. Now we shall see about selection to grate. I am selecting honeycomb and sponge by rectangle selection. And shift S and select selection to grate. It moved little bit to grid. To check it clearly, I am selecting sponge object alone. Go to top viewport by clicking tilde key and select top. Then view menu, select frame selected to frame the active object closer until fit. This is the sponge object with its pivot point. Select move tool. Move the object and place it in middle of the grid square. Press Shift S and selection to grid. Now the pivot is aligned to the right side top corner of the grid square. Moving the object closer to left bottom of grid square. Again press Shift S and selection to grid. Now it is snapped to its nearest grid point. Now we shall see about cursor to active. This is cursor and sponge is active object. Right click, snap menu and select cursor to active. Cursor moved to sponge pivot point's location. Now select on teapot, press shift S and select cursor to active. Cursor moved to teapot. Now cursor moved to beam. Now cursor moved to star. To move cursor to its default position, shift S and select cursor to world origin. Now we shall see about cursor to selected. We know cursor will move to the selected object. When more than one object is selected, it moves to the selected object's middle point. You can see it moved to the center point of the gizmo. Now three objects are selected. Now gizmo is here. Now select cursor to selected. It moved to the center point of the selected object. Now all objects are selected. It does the same. When we select single object, cursor move to the object. To move cursor to its default position, shift S and select cursor to world origin. Wherever we place cursor, it brings the cursor to world origin. Select star and now apply selection to cursor. Star moved to cursor. Undo it. Undo and apply cursor to selected. Now cursor moved to star. We will check the cursor to grid option. Go to top view. Place the cursor near grid point. And apply cursor to grid. It moves to the nearest grid point. Now we shall see about selection to cursor. Keep offset. Select beam and apply selection to cursor keep offset. Beam moved to cursor. Now selecting beam and teapot and apply keep offset. Both object moved to cursor and the distance is still maintained. Now select three objects and apply keep offset. Now selecting 4 objects and applying keep offset. Now star and sponge selected and apply keep offset. The distance is always maintained and moved to cursor with the keep offset. The distance is always maintained and moved to cursor with the keep offset option. All objects are selected. Now applying selection to cursor. All objects pivot are moved to the cursor's pivot. Undo and apply selection to cursor. Keep offset. The distance is always maintained when multiple objects selected. This 3D cursor option is unique to Blender from other popular 3D programs. 3D cursor at initial stage, it may feel pretty confusing. If you understand it, it will be a great time saver on your regular 3D process. Happy snapping with 3D cursor. Thank you. Have a great day.